Hi, in this video we are going to learn how to create an audio IMF supplemental package. There are some cases when we need to export an audio adjustment. This may be because an error was reported in QC, or we have a picture change that is affecting the audio as well. In the previous video, we learned that IMF supplemental packages can be used to replace parts of a timeline. This saves tremendous amounts of render time and storage space for video. With audio, it is Netflix's best practice to replace the entire audio track instead of creating patches or edit points when you need to deliver an update. Creating an edit point or cut in audio could result in ticks and pops in encoding. An IMF supplemental package that replaces audio will only contain those audio tracks that were changed, as well as updated timeline metadata that will combine these tracks with assets delivered in previous IMF packages. IMF supplemental packages allow us to replace audio without re-rendering or deliver a single video frame. Any supplemental IMF package must be created from the last successful delivered IMF package. This supplemental package will reuse previously delivered MXF track files. Let's generate an audio supplemental IMF package for an audio patch. Let's open our project that we used for our previous IMF packages. Resolve needs the file path of the MXF files from previous IMF packages. Otherwise, the media will be offline. We will reuse our previous project to create our audio-only supplemental IMF package. If you don't have your project anymore, you should import the previous delivered IMF packages into the media pool to make sure that Resolve knows the file path. If you have questions about this setting, click this link. To create an audio supplemental, we must do it from the last successful delivered CPL. In this case, we will use the video supplemental IMF package from our last video. Let's search in the media storage the files we are going to use in our exercise. Here, we are going to see our video supplemental IMF package and a folder with the audio patch we need to insert. Let's drag our OLB1 and audio patch folder under the master bin into the media pool. Now let's move to the edit page. In the edit page, we are going to create a timeline based from our previous supplemental IMF package. Right-click on the file and select Create New Timeline Using Composition Playlist. This will make sure that all the updates that we will make can be saved as a supplemental IMF package. As a name, we will write supplemental underscore 2 underscore 2020-1220. Click Create. We just created a new timeline based on our composition playlist. If we made a timeline using the traditional method and then drag the IMF on an empty timeline, it would not work. The audio patch would not be rendered as a supplemental. You always need to select Create New Timeline from Composition Playlist to create a supplemental IMF package. Otherwise, we will render a complete IMF package instead. Now we need to insert our audio adjustment. As you notice, in the media pool we have a full clip of audio. We don't have a short segment with the adjustment. Netflix prefers audio redelivery as single, full program tracks rather than in patches. This reduces the possibility of introducing audio artifacts like ticks and pops during the encoding process. For that reason, to export an audio fix to Netflix, you must replace the whole audio track, even if the adjustment is something of short duration. In our example, we need to replace the center channel from the 5.1 mix. Before we start making changes, let's lock the video track and the stereo audio track. We will not need to make any updates on them, so let's be sure that we don't do so. Now we need to delete our 5.1 mix and add all the mono tracks we had before and the new track with the adjustment. In the media pool, we are going to switch from the thumbnail view to the list view. And we need to drag these files to the timeline in the correct order. Left, right, the center track with the adjustment, low frequency effects, left surround, and right surround. Remember, if the audio files are longer than the video files, you need to trim them. With the audio files inside the timeline, we are going to move to the Fairlight page. Inside the Fairlight page, we are going to select the 6 audio channels, and in the Fairlight menu at the top of the interface, we are going to choose the option Link Group. Inside this menu, we will select the audio channels, and at the bottom right next to Link As, we will hit the 5.1 preset. This will create the correct channel mapping for Netflix. Let's move to the edit page. It is crucial to check that our audio tracks are in sync. In our case, we have a 2-pop sound at the beginning of our audio tracks. That will help us to verify the sync. Let's check if they are synced. Now, we need to trim the 2-pop sound. Remember that Resolve will fill up this gap with silence. Finally, let's move our Audio 5.1 mix to be the first track in our timeline. Let's right-click in the track and select Move Link Track Up. This is optional, but we are doing it to keep audio tracks with the same order as the other videos. Also, it is important to make sure that all tracks within your IMF have the same duration. In this case, you will have 5.1, 2.0, and video track. Let's move to the deliver page. In the render settings section, we will select the IMF Netflix custom preset. It is good to mention that Netflix does not require a naming convention for IMF packages. However, if you are looking for guidance on folder naming, Netflix provides some optional best practices here. Next to location, click Browse, and we are going to find a folder for our IMF supplemental package. In the file name, we are going to press Paste, and we will see the already saved name. This information is unique to each show. Project title, season and episode, picture version, in this case our supplemental package 2, creation date, and CPL UUID. The CPL UUID is only available after the package was created, so we have to update the folder manually afterwards. To create a supplemental IMF, we need to go into the video tab first. Even if your supplement is only audio, we need to make sure to check the supplemental package checkbox. If we don't select this option, the render file will not be supplemental, and Resolve will render the whole timeline as a new complete IMF package. All the other settings that are grayed out are part of the Netflix preset, and you cannot change those. Finally, in the composition settings in the content kind drop-down menu, select Episode. And that's all we need to do in the video tab. Let's move up and click the audio tab. Here we need to correctly route our audio tracks stereo and 5.1 from our timeline into the IMF. By default, our audio is set to all timeline tracks. We want to manually set this, so we will change the drop-down to timeline track. You will see that this is a 5.1 track, and we are routing timeline track 1 to output track 1. We have to add another track for the 2.0 as well. Press the plus icon to create this and set it to timeline track. Make sure that the 7 timeline track is set to output track 2. You should not change the language code or metadata because we are creating a supplemental package. That's all we need to do to export our audio only supplemental IMF package. Let's hit add to render queue and then start render. Finally, let's check our IMF package. We will do it first inside DaVinci Resolve and then in the Finder. We want to verify the supplemental package in the same project. If we would create a new project, Resolve would not know where the previous IMF packages are located. Therefore, the media will be offline. In the project, we are going to move to the media page. And in the media storage, let's search for the folder we created. Inside the folder, we should see just one clip. This is your supplemental IMF package. You can see a small logo that says HDR. This is telling us we have an IMF HDR package. Let's drag our IMF package into the media pool. Here we are going to open the metadata menu, and we need to check that the information of the file matches with the setting we created in our IMF. In this case, we can see that our IMF is Dolby Vision UHD and has 8 tracks of audio, exactly as we did. Finally, let's create a timeline with our file. Right-click in the clip and select Create New Timeline Using Composition Playlist. In the name, let's write QC to review and hit Create. If you don't see the option Create New Timeline Using Composition Playlist, will mean that your file is not a valid IMF package. This will create your timeline and several folders that contain the actual MXF synthesis from your new and previous packages. If you open the folder of our audio-only supplemental, you can find more technical metadata fields for the MXF synths in the list view. You will probably want to verify things like audio codec, frame rate, audio channels, and sample rate. Now let's move to the edit page and make sure that everything is correct. We recommend you to do a spot check at the begin, middle, and end of the timeline and verify the changes that you made. After checking the IMF in Resolve, let's open the file in the Finder to quickly review all the different components. Here we are going to find one new MXF file, carrying our new 5.1 track and the rest of the metadata. We also want to compare the CPL of our supplemental IMF package against the CPL of our previous supplemental IMF package before we deliver it. We want to verify that we only update the 5.1 track in the new CPL. There should not be any changes in the 2.0 and video track. For more information on the CPL, click this link. Hopefully, this video has provided enough information on how to create an audio patch supplemental. Make sure to watch our next video, where we will create a non-branded IMF package.